Hey guys, this is a friend Mainak from Civil Center, and I welcome all of you back to our channel. Another video on STAT. So friends, in today's video we'll show you the full process of designing a small building room in STAT using the Indian codes. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So first of all, we need to insert some coordinates in STAT, and before that, let me tell you, we have to save this file. I have created a separate folder to save the STAT file. As you can see, I have created a separate folder for that, and I have also named it. So this is important because all the STAT files will be saved in that particular folder. So now we can get started with working. So let's insert normal coordinates here. So if you go to the top view, then it will be helpful for you to insert the coordinates. So as you can see, this is the default coordinate system which you observe in STAT. This is the x-axis and this is the z-axis. So if we start from this point at 0, 0, so let's just click the tab button in your particular computer. So this is the first coordinate, it is 0, 0. So let the next x coordinate be your 4, and y coordinate will be 0 because we are designing this building for the plinth level. So and then for the z, the coordinate can be 0. So we have made this coordinate and this coordinate, and next let's go for a separate coordinate. So we'll go with x as 0, y as a 0, and z as your -4. So as you can see, we have made a coordinate here. So instead of -4, if you just give it as +4, you can also edit this as +4 also, as per your choice. Just do this as +4, that will also do. So as you can see, this coordinate has been done. So next coordinate we want as x will be 4, y will be automatically 0, and z will be 4. So like this, we can make the coordinate system in the STAT. So now, the next thing which we can do, we can check it in the isometric view. As you can see, this is the view from the particular 3D view. So again, we'll go back to the particular top view, and we'll this time use the option of add beams to add these beams together. So while adding the beams, we'll remember that we'll go for left to right and bottom to top. So like this, even if it's a structure with the many spans, for that also we'll follow the same procedure. So after adding the beams, we can again check in the 3D view. So as you can see, this represents our plinth level, and we'll add more floors above it. So now you can select this, and after selecting this, you can use the option of translation repeat. Y direction is above in this case, so we'll just give this Y, and the spacing, let's give it as 3 meters. Just click on here and then OK. So as you can see, the particular next floor has been made. Now, when you have a building, make sure that you connect only the nodes which have the columns. So we'll connect the nodes. We're not using the link steps because using the link steps, all the nodes will be connected. But in place of an actual building, there will be columns, and only the columns you have to connect. So suppose we have 4 columns in this particular building. Let's connect these 4 columns together. And after connecting this 4 columns, we can just go to the front view and then click on escape and then select the columns and the beams of the ground floor slab, and then go to translation repeat, make it this Y, and give this a spacing of, well, let's say 3 meters. Click here and then OK. So as you can see, now the steps have been copied. So now we can assign some supports to it. So you have this various option here of general, and then you have the option of support, and here you can create a support. This fixed support which we'll create, it represents that the foundation part and the column above the foundation, which will be below the plinth level, are monolithic with the structure which we are making. So we'll just click on this support, and we'll just select this nodes. We'll just press Control. You can use your scroll buttons in the keyboard to rotate this model, and with the help of Control, we'll just select this 4 points where we have columns. When you have in the practical structure, when you have columns, you need to give supports below every column and not in every intersection. Okay, so we'll just assign this, and after this has been assigned, then what we can do is we can define the material properties also. So we'll go to the properties and we'll go to define. So now in the actual case, you can define different properties for different levels. For now, we'll just give a property of 0.25 into 0.25 for all the columns as well as the beams. But you can assign, you know, separate properties for the columns and beams as well. So after, you know, defining this, we'll just select. Okay, let's select the entire structure here, and we'll give this property to assign to selected beam. Just assign this, and after that, what we'll do, we'll go towards the loading part. So we'll go toward the loads and definitions, and let's go to this particular load case details. And before that, also you can go to seismic definitions and add a seismic definition here. And we'll go, you can select the code of the country in which you want to design this. Let's go with the IS 1893, which is a seismic code according to Indian codes. We'll just click on generate, and after we click on generate, we'll give the zone of the city in which you want to design, and we'll select here OMRF, because if you, for the normal buildings with masonry buildings with door into door and window, you can select this particular OMRF. So after selecting this OMRF, you can select this medium soil and medium soil, and we are designing RCC building here, concrete buildings, and so we are using this, and just click on generate. And after clicking on generate, you can click on add. After clicking on add, you just click close, because the remaining things we'll do in the stat editor, that is easier. So load case details we'll add, and let's add some loads here. So in, let's add some dead seismic load first. So there is seismic load in two directions, since it's a lateral load in the X and the Z. So it will be SLX, and next will be your SLZ. And then let's add some dead load here. To the dead load, we'll do the DL, and live load will do as LL. So like this, we have added the load successfully. And now let's add a factor in the seismic load, self-weight factor. -1. Let's do with this 1, and this value also, it depends on the IS 1893. You can this can be you know, particular 1 as well, 0.3 as well. So it depends, but let's take as 1 for now. And here are the dead loads. So let's add some dead loads. So what are the dead loads we are going to take? Load of the slab, because we are not going to assign any slab, since the slab design is not possible, not economical in the stat software. So we'll not assign any slab. Instead, we'll assign the slab loads, and also we'll assign the loads of the walls which are above this particular beams. So in the y direction, we'll just give it a self weight of -1. That is, it will act from the top to bottom, so it's -1. If it goes from the bottom to top, it will be +1. Since the dead load acts like this from top to bottom, it will be -1. So we have added the self weight factor. Next, let's add for the particular wall load. So wall load, let's take as -5.5. You can calculate the wall load which you're going to take load for the walls by multiplying the thickness of the wall into the unit weight of the brick plus mortar into the height of the wall. So like this, you can calculate this value. Let's take -5.5 for now, and click on add. So after doing this, you can just go to this particular floor load, and we'll add the floor load. So floor load is calculation is very simple. It's actually the thickness of the slab into the unit weight of concrete. So if the thickness of the slab, let me open the calculator here, let's show the calculation. So suppose if the thickness of the slab is your 150 mm, so it will be 0.15 into the unit weight of concrete, which is 25 kilonewton per meter cube. So the slab weight will be in this case 3.75 kilonewton per meter square. But let's take a thickness of 100 mm, so this will be 25 into 0.1, which will be 2.5 kilonewton per meter square. So depending on the slab thickness, you can assign this particular pressure. So once you make the structure, or before the structure also, if you can design the slab, and then you can find out this thickness, according to that thickness you can provide the pressure here. So let's give it -2.5, because it acts again acts from the top to bottom. Add, and the range, you have to define that. You can define the range here. You can go to edit, and now the range is interesting. So this is 0 in, let's start with y. So this is 0 0, so the range will start from this 3. This is 3 and this is 6. So we have to define a range where 3 and 6 both come. So let's go with 2 to 7. So in that, these two floors will come, because in the bottom floor we don't have any slab because this is the plinth level. So x range, let's define as x range. So minimum x which you have here is your 0. So x range is defined as minus 1, and maximum x which you have is 4. So minus 1 to 5, 0 and 4 both come here. Similarly, the z range is also similar here. In the actual structure, you have to do that. Check that, and then I'll just change this. And as you can see, this live load, sorry, the floor load has been assigned. Now we have to do for the wall load as well. So for the wall loads, you can just select this, and then you can select the beams in which you want to assign the wall load. So I'll go to the front view, and in this case, I can select the all the walls. In the actual case, for the actual structure, you can select the walls which have the load of the 10-inch wall, which are the load of the particular 5-inch wall, or the different walls, and then you can assign them. But here we are taking as all have the same walls, so we are selecting like this, and we'll just select this option of beams, and then yes. So after this has been assigned, let's assign the self weight as well, and we'll do this self weight as assigned. So this has been assigned. This self weight also we can assign. This also self weight, the seismic load, assigned to view. Then next we'll go to STAT editor, and after going to STAT editor, we'll just save this model once again. And after going to STAT editor, as you can see, now you have to understand this particular program to do this better. So here we have all the properties of this loading. So above this particular option of your seismic load, we can, as you can see, this zone has been defined. Here we can import some of the loadings. So as you can see from the dead load, as you can see, which we have in the dead load option, we have the self weight and the member loads. So here in these particular member loads, and also you have the flow loads as well. So in this particular option of your dead loads, we can just copy this and we can just paste this here. So here we'll just remove the sign, and we'll remove the y direction as well, because it acts like this. So here it will be member weight. Please know that you can do this manually as well, but we are just taking using the STAT editor for doing this. Minus 5.5, we'll just remove the symbol and the gy. Flow load also, we'll just go with weight, and we'll just delete the symbol here. And here also we'll just remove the gy symbol. And now this is the particular load due to the dead load. Since the since seismic load considers the particular dead load as well as the live load. For the live load, we have to give a live load here also. So for the flow load, which we have in the dead load part, as you can see here, dead load part has this member load and the flow load as well. So we'll copy this flow load, and then we'll enter this in the live load part. So live load will be minus 2 for the residential. So we'll do this as minus 2. This changes has been done. And now in the seismic load also, as you can see here, if the live load is 2, then we have to take 0.25% of that. If it is more than 3, we'll take 0.5%. So 0.25% we can add here in the particular seismic load part. As you can see here, this is the particular member weight, floor weight. Now in this particular floor load, we can add the particular seismic load part. So it will be, let's do it as 3. So now this floor weight is 3, this member weight is 5.5, and everything else is defined. So now everything else is defined. We'll just close this particular file. So after saving this, so now one error will come. So we don't need to worry about that, because that error will be removed when we add analysis and print. So after adding analysis print, that particular error will be removed. So we'll just proceed with this. Then now we can go to this particular option of analysis and print. And after that, we can add analysis. If you please note that if you may add multiple times, there is no option to delete this. So make sure that you use this command wisely. But And there will be no problem in designing the software if you add this analysis multiple times. The only problem will be there will be some errors which will be generated, which will show due to multiple analysis. So let me add some multiple analysis to show you, but you shouldn't do that. You should do that one time only. I'm just adding this analysis processes, and after that, next step which we're going to do is going to we're going to go to analyze, and then we are going to do this analysis, run analysis. So analysis, run analysis. Now we're going to check whether we have any errors. Obviously, some warnings will come because we have added this perform analysis multiple times, but there shouldn't be any error. So now, as you can check, there are no errors here. Only warnings are coming due to this particular multiple times which you have used of analysis. As you can see this here, the warnings. And obviously, we haven't added the slab, so the notes for the slab is there. Remaining our model is clean. So this, if you follow this process for all buildings, then you can get a clean model. Only if your member is failing, then it will show some warnings. Bye.